Welcome back. This week in studio, Damon Harrison, defensive lineman for William Penn. NFL draft starting this weekend. It's going Thursday, Friday, Saturday. How excited are you right now?
I'm too excited. You know, I've been waiting a long time for this day, you know, and I'm ready to get it all over with.
So how are things kind of like settling in for you? Because I know last time we talked to you was about like a month and a half ago when you were just training, and it was just kind of some initial questions that we were asking you, but it's right upon you right now. So how's it all feel right now?
I mean, it's kind of surreal because, you know, back then I was waiting for, like, it needs to hurry up. But, you know, those days have came by real quick. So, you know, now I just wanted to slow down some now. But it's a couple of days away, and, you know, hopefully I have a home by the end of the week.
Is there a little moment of relaxation now for you going into this weekend? You've done the training. You've done the hard work. Now you get to see how that all falls out for you.
Yeah, I mean, it is. Talking to the guys that I've trained with and, you know, the trainers, you know, everybody's excited. Everybody, this week is finally the week everybody gets to relax, you know, just waiting and see how everything plays out. A lot of guys are flying all over the country doing interviews. Some guys are in New York. And, you know, I'll be here in Oskaloosa.
Right. And is there a special event that's going to be held for you? I mean, is it just going to be you at home just hanging out? Or is there something going on where your teammates are going to be able to join you as well?
Well, they're trying to set up something right now. They were trying to do a barbecue, you know, that day and, you know, just sit around, play games and just watch the draft. But, you know, I told them I don't want to have that on my mind right now. You know, it'll be a long day Saturday, the day I'm projected to go. So, you know, I'd rather just sit somewhere and just relax. So I plan on going somewhere with the family, like take the kids to Chuck E. Cheese or something until I get the call, if I get the call.
What are you going to do when you get the call?
I mean, I'll probably cry. I'm not going to lie. I'll probably end up crying, you know, because that'll be one moment in my life, you know, I can just honestly just be proud of something that I've done, you know, and I just can't wait till that day when I get that call.
At this moment, it doesn't matter necessarily if you are picked up in the fifth to seventh round. Mm-hmm. If you go into free agency, you still have an opportunity to be picked up. And I was kind of messing around, and I looked on your Facebook. You said it's either the Colts or the Titans might be interested in you if you are a free agent.
Yeah, so it was the Colts. The Colts sent me a letter, and I talked to my agent about it. He said that's pretty much standard procedure. They send out letters to guys, you know, let them know if you don't get drafted, we are interested in you signing with the Colts as a free agent, because they say they feel like I can make the organization, you know, better because they're headed in another direction. So, you know, that's still good to know if I don't get drafted, I at least have somewhere that I could go.
And the last time Penn had this kind of buzz going around campus with a guy who's going to has the potential to go into the NFL was Andy Stokes. That was back in 04, 05, and he was a tight end. And he was the very last guy to get drafted by the Patriots. And, I mean, does that pass through? I mean, does that go through your head where you're just sitting there waiting and waiting, and that might be, you might be that guy, or, you know, you might be that, you could maybe be drafted earlier than what you thought?
Yeah, it does. On my Twitter page, there's a site called Mr. Irrelevant, and, you know, around this time, they're doing who you think will be the Mr. Irrelevant, and the guy actually, he tweeted me because a couple of people said that it might be me because the Colts have the last pick in the draft. So they told me it might be me, and he was explaining to me how the whole Mr. Irrelevant thing goes. They have a parade that week, you know, and they're celebrating I can't remember what he said, the irrelevant or something like that he said.
So any favorite teams that you're hoping to go to? I know we talked a little bit about that earlier as well. What are you kind of hoping for there?
I would love to go home, you know, back home to Louisiana to play for the Saints. But, you know, just getting a shot, you know, just proving that I belong in the NFL, you know, that'll be fine for me.
I know going home would be perfect. But, you know, with some of the things that are going on with the team right now, and, you know, they are changing up a lot of things where they're going to maybe want new people. Obviously, they want new people in the coaching roles. But, I mean, players the same. I mean, is that something you're ready to enter into, something that obviously you weren't even a part of?
You know, that'll be difficult walking into a situation like that in New Orleans. But, you know, at the same time, I've overcome a lot of adversity in my life. So, you know, another situation like that would just be another testimony added to my life story. So, you know, I would love the opportunity to go down there and make a difference.
What's the one thing that you're focused on this weekend?
Family. You know, family, like you said, the hard part is done. And, you know, just I find myself a lot now, you know, just thinking about how life is going to be in a few months or next year, how much different, you know, I'll be as a person. And, you know, and I really look forward to that.